Welcome to Book Talks,
you naughty one.
Today we're going to talk about anal sex. Trust me, I'm not an expert on how to make anal sex pleasurable. However, with my many years of experience as a GI nurse, I can help you save your buddy if you are going to have anal sex. I'm Nurse Wong, and this is Butt Talks. Before we dive in, I want to let you know that I do not recommend having anal sex since it's not the most buddy friendly. You might be exposed to higher risks of sexually transmitted infections, STIs, or sexually transmitted diseases, STDs, hemorrhoids, colon irritation, pain and bleeding, anal fissures, tear in the anal tissue, fecal incontinence, loss of control over pooping, and in some serious cases, rectal prolapse. The end of your large intestine falls out of your anus.
Oh no!
But I do understand that anal sex is very important to many people. So, here are my top 5 tips to protect your buddy if you are going to have anal sex. Number 1. Clean well. For anal sex, know that there's bacteria living in and around your anus, and there will likely be some poop involved. So cleaning well is a must. Shower before and after. Wash your buddy well with mild soap and warm water. Consider an enema to get rid of poop inside your buddy. Cut your nails to reduce the risk of scratching the skin. Soak your buddy after for some relief. Check out our How to Clean Your Butt video for more information. It's virtually impossible to get pregnant from anal sex, but you should still wear a condom because no matter how much you clean your anus and rectum, microscopic fecal matter will always be present. Using a condom acts as a barrier to protect against the spread of infection and disease. Number 2, lubricate well. Your anus has no natural lubrication. Penetration without lubrication can tear the delicate skin inside the anus, which can lead to bleeding and pain. All sorts of bacteria and viruses can be passed from person to person through broken skin. So always use lubrication for anal sex. Choose water-based lubricants such as KY jelly, as oil-based ones such as Vaseline can break latex condoms. I will leave links of water-based lubricants I recommend in the description below. Apply not only around your anus, but also the tissue inside. Tissue inside the anus is very sensitive, so try to use gloves for a smoother application. Be sure to use a generous amount. It's better to be safe than sorry. Number 3,
don't double dip.
Don't put the penis inside the mouth or in the vagina after it's been inside the anus.
It might not taste very good.
All jokes aside, poop contains organisms that can cause disease. Even a tiny amount of poop can get in your mouth or vagina and cause infection. It's definitely not pretty. Make sure you clean up first and change condoms. Number 4, stop if it's uncomfortable. Don't engage in anal sex if you already have existing tears or irritation. Your current conditions such as hemorrhoids can get worse. Watch our video on hemorrhoids on how to treat them. Your body is always trying to communicate with you. Take things slowly. If you have pain, please stop. It's an important sign. An uncomfortable penetration of the anus will feel like a colonoscopy with no sedation. Go slow and regularly check in with your partner to make sure both of you are physically and emotionally comfortable. Some people use numbing medications such as lidocaine on the buddy area to lessen the potential pain. However, that doesn't always protect you from the future problems. Try to avoid using them so you can have awareness of your tolerance. Use a safety word to alert them in case things are going bananas. It's important that your anal muscles are relaxed. This not only makes the experience more pleasurable, but it also reduces the risk of tearing or discomfort. Number 5. Get tested before and after. This is almost a no-brainer, but many times people just skip it. It's a good idea to get STD screening to protect yourself, your partners, and to stay informed. Most tests require a urine or blood sample, but note that there is no single test for every STD. Talk to your healthcare provider about what tests to take and things to consider. Again, I don't recommend anal sex, but if you choose to engage in it, do it safely with the tips we went over today. Talk with your partner, do enough research, and be prepared for it. Remember to take care of your buddy and have fun out there. If you like our video, press the like button below. Comment on what you would like to learn about next. For more tips and tricks from Butt Talks, subscribe to our channel. Have a great poop day!